Okay, so where are we at with tech?
It's like, what the fuck?
I'm expected to compete with Social Security and 401k.
Yeah, ignore that, because I haven't done my research on that. Let's start with the...
You got the Volt batteries on catching...
Oh, yeah. Oh, no, we're going to go on everybody today.
A lot of things that I posted on Twitter.
Actually, I saw that before you posted it, but I saw that you posted it, so I'm like, I haven't screwed this. You know, I was walking through the mall, and they had a Volt in there, and I just kind of, like, inched away from the thing, and I'm like, okay, it's gonna blow up, everybody, get down, it's a bomb! I have mixed feelings. To this day, I still cannot figure out why the government and the hippy-dippy people like the Volt, but hate Ford's counterpart.
I don't know, sometimes I don't understand the reasoning. A lot of political mantra out there is just to be spiteful. Just to really be spiteful, and even a lot of it is profitable, believe it or not. There's profit in having spite against something else.
That's always the case.
So, it's always going to be the case.
I'm just hoping any of the Ewoks who are driving around in their Ewok mobiles don't spontaneously combust.
You know, it's like you read my Twitter.
I just think about this. You're an Ewok. You're driving along. You get involved in a minor fender bender. Oh, is everybody okay? Are you okay, little Ewu and Awa? Okay, we're all okay. It's like they exchange insurance information. They go home. They park the car in the garage. I mean, that'd just be the fitting end to a day.
Freaking technology. I mean, I don't care. I honestly don't care if it's electric, hydrogen, whatever. But electric cars are nowhere. Unless they have those ones that, I forget the name of the company, but they're extraordinarily expensive, like $100,000+ that I think they're very fast and they can last a long time, but the cars I'd say that are more obtainable in price, my wife couldn't even make it one way to her work in like the Nissan.
I would say for like real intertown stuff, like for people who are really urban,
yeah.
They're
an electric scooter. Yeah, you're right.
They're enough. The big problem with the current electric vehicles is if you factor in how long the batteries last and the cost of replacing the batteries,
you're right. Batteries are not environmentally friendly at all.
It's
just not the best at electricity either.
Well, now, what's missing for an electric vehicle to really make absolute sense, both in terms of cost and environmental and everything else, is basically capacitors have not yet caught up to the point that they're as portable or modular as batteries. But if instead of using batteries, you were using like carbon nanocell capacitors, then that'd be great. That'd be great because you could store...
What's inside a capacitor? The filament that is able to hold a charge. Once that gets more efficient, the capacitors will get we can't hold.
Batteries will basically. For people who don't understand what the difference between a battery and a capacitor is, a battery it is not. Basically, we have a really hard time storing electricity. A battery is our best bet at that right now, but it continues. It continues to discharge. A capacitor would not discharge unless you discharge it. It would, which means you could...
Eventually,
odds are you're going to use it long before it's not. The reality is it's the best thing we have for storing unused electricity. You know, we could generate that's also something necessary for switching over to a pure solar system, to a pure wind system, things that aren't always at peak performance, but are in excess of need at times, but you can't store the excess, and it's a missing piece. The technology will come, but it isn't there right now.
Yeah, and quite honestly, I actually think gasoline is quite efficient in what we're doing. I mean, if you Now you have catalytic converters. If cars essentially are well maintained, there's not this. And see, that's the other thing, is that there's so many people that are caught up in this man-made climate, change, where it used to be man-made global warming. Now it's just man-made climate change, because obviously it doesn't warm. So now if it rains funny, any type of weather pattern can be used.
I'm sorry, Marcel, I remember when it was global cooling.
Oh, I know, back in the 70s. I don't know what the hell's going on. I mean, it's just, look, isn't it ironic that everything reaches a tax? How is a tax going to help save the planet? It's not.
Well, it disincentivizes bad behavior.
Yeah. And that's what I'm saying, like these Occupy guys. If they have a problem lining the pockets of bankers, why don't they have a problem lining the pockets of politicians?
Shh. that's coming dangerously close to making sense. I don't know. I honestly, that's the little thing that always bugs.
It's not producing anything.
Well, no, but that's the thing, honestly, that bugs me out the wazoo about Man Bear Pig. And I refuse to call him anything else.
Yeah.
But people don't realize this about Man Bear Pig. Man Bear Pig has basically hedged all his bets. He's gone all in on the idea of carbon credits. Basically, he's financially screwed if we don't implement carbon credits. Which,
we're not going
to
carbon credits.
Well, then he's financially screwed, because Man Bear Pig hedged everything on, basically being primed to benefit from the carbon credit system. So,
carbon credit, to be honest, you probably have more concern that transaction tax they want to bring back is more. See, the governments are just trying to find ways of lining pockets to do. It's extraordinary how easy we can lose hard-earned money from poor people who do pay taxes. Maybe not as much as the rich, but they nonetheless pay it. Whether it's a sales tax or a regulatory charge on their cell phone, that they're paying a tax in some form or another. Right?
You've hit the nail on the head right there. That's something that bugs the heck out of me. And heaven forbid if you call those non-tax taxes taxes. Because that is what they are, no matter what you... Oh, no, sir, that's not a tax. That's an administrative fee. No, it's a tax. You can call it whatever you want. It's... For those of you who don't know what we're talking about with the transaction fee, one of the things the Hill is kicking around trying to squeeze through is the idea that every time you commit a transaction, swipe your debit card, deposit your paycheck, take money out of the bank, put money into the bank. Right,
that's over the internet.
Yeah. Basically, any time money moves from A to B, even if it's from your hand to your other hand, in terms of from bank account to bank account, the government's going to take a percentage of it.
In the computer world, they call that a worm.
Didn't some hackers, do this? Oh, we're just going to gobble up those extra pennies. You won't miss them. Except the government's going to take whole pennies. You know?
We gotta get tech before everybody's...
Yeah, I know. Everybody's getting bad now. Okay, no. Moving on to something that will get people on. We talked about the exploding Ewok mobiles. For those of you who are fans of The Office, apparently Dundermifflin is Hewlett Packard. Because some hackers have figured out ways to send certain HP printers commands, and basically they can make them catch on fire. HP says, no, we've patched this, they can't do it anymore, so hopefully your printer driver's up to date if you're using an HP printer.
MS, I went to Microsoft Store, and there is a huge chance now that my AT&T phone will be a Windows phone.
Marcel, what has happened to your brain?
Man, I was very impressed, dude. I sat there for an hour playing with Windows Mobile over there in the Microsoft Store. I was impressed.
Okay.
My Verizon phone is probably going to go Android of some sort. I really still like the Razer, because it can connect to that the new book they're coming out with, you know, like the like a laptop type thing. I'm waiting to see how this the Nexus S thing is going to turn out. But yeah, my Verizon is likely to go Android, and my AT&T is likely to go to Windows Phone.
The if you go Verizon, you'll benefit because Verizon's rolling
out.
I
can't have Verizon, but my Palm Pre is Verizon, and I had my iPhone that I sold, which was on AT&T, and now it's just replaced by an LG phone that will go to a smartphone. I miss having simultaneous voice and data. There's just no doubt. I miss it. So.
Well, no, and short of using VoIP, you're not going to get that because of the way Verizon implemented their network. Yeah. However, Verizon is they're doing exactly what we thought the mobile companies were going to do. They're rolling out a Netflix competitor, and of course, even though it's going to use data, it's not going to count. You know, it's going to be basically, oh, buy the Verizon service, and it doesn't count. It's just... You knew they were going to do it. You know, eventually Verizon and AT&T are going to do it, and here it starts. You know, it's like, oh, we have a thing to compete with that thing you can get somewhere else. Only if you use the other thing, it counts against your data, and if you use ours, it doesn't. It's like...
Yeah. I know, because right now, HP is going to bury WebOS. They're going to sit on it.
Yeah.
And they're going to sit on it. There's no news about it. They said they were going to have news about it, but it's over. They're going to just basically sit on it, it's going to die.
They're going to sit on it, it's going to sit on a shelf somewhere, they're going to lose complete interest in it, and one of two things is going to happen to it. They're going to sit on it, never use it, and go patent sue crazy, or they're going to sell it to somebody else who will then integrate it into something else.
Yeah, supposedly tomorrow we're going to hear something, but you know, if they say, oh, we're... gonna hold on to it.
No, you know what? If HP publishes this big thing between the time it takes to get this published that says, oh, we're gonna go gung ho with web, we apologize. But it's HP, people, honestly. You know,
and I'm not sure what Rim's gonna do. And I'm hearing just rumors. I would love BBX to come about, but I just don't know.
No, haven't you heard? RIM is renaming BBX BlackBerry 10. Why, I have no idea. So basically, they're gonna like merge it into the other side of BlackBerry. Which means it might change its form as a result. It's not known if it's gonna do that yet or not. Although, getting back on the Windows phone thing side of things... So you like it for the slaty Sony. Do you really want that to be your desktop, though?
Which operating system?
Phone 7.
No, I mean, I'm going to have my Windows... We already discussed... You already know my opinion of Windows 8.
Okay. Well, I'm just surprised to hear you go, I like Windows 8 as long as it's not Windows 8.
Good. Did I say that on the phone? I think I made it very clear that... On a mobile platform, man, it was quick. I hate to say it, its responsiveness and its intuitiveness, I think, outperforms iOS easily.
That's not hard to do given some of the things
iOS doesn't have a high
level. Okay, name me one platform out there that doesn't currently outperform iOS. Yes. I mean, it's just one of those,
Now, what the hell would Oracle do with buying WebOS? It would not go into mobile space anymore. I'm curious what Oracle would do with WebOS.
They'd probably go sue everybody. The same way they tried to do it when they got Java.
Yeah, so Samsung, HTC, Amazon, Oracle are considering, have at least rumored to be interested in acquiring WebOS. I don't know. HP, I'm just so upset. I had a lot of hope in them.
Yeah, but it's HP. Place. When has HP not done this?
I was wrong. I admit it. I'll eat my words.
Well, it's the reputation HP's got. They kind of always, like, they have the pieces, but they somehow manage to always drop the ball. And the fact that they have Meg in there now, I'm just like, no. No, Meg is not that type of... No, yeah, I'm sorry. It's not going to happen. It's like, it'll be interesting to see what happens there. But who would be smart to buy it would be Google. Because on top of the other stuff they're buying,
to complete the whole cycle, then that Duarte guy would have...
Yeah, but...
And Android, at that point... Any doubt that even the purest Apple fanboy would have of Android's advantage would be totally cemented.
Yeah, but that's actually one of the reasons why it would be smart for Google to make that purchase. I actually don't want Google to make that purchase. I want somebody else.
Like Amazon. I wish Amazon would. That'd be interesting.
I don't know if I want it to be Amazon, because the Amazon would probably just use it as a shell on top of Android. Who I would like to purchase WebOS would be somebody who is going to continue development of WebOS, and they're going to take it head-to-head against...
What if Apple bought it and used it to change iOS?
That would be interesting, but the problem would be Apple has never been good at getting out of the all things Apple box. And I want whoever buys WebOS to continue to let it be, you know, forcing everybody to compete against each other. Because we don't want less people, we want more. We want them all fighting against each other so this stuff keeps getting better. And I don't want that cycle to slow down, I want it to speed up. Because, I mean, with ARM 6 coming out and everything else, I mean, these could be desktop replacement systems in 3 years. If they're forced to run that way. If they're forced to just out-compete each other to that point. Otherwise, it'll take a decade and computing will go backwards for 5 years. And I don't want that.
Yeah. Interesting. I will say, right now, I am very impressed with Windows Mobile 7. It performed well. I liked how the live tiles worked. I tested the copying and pasting. It even has a card system similar to WebOS, but you can't kill, you know, the task with it. And I'm very disappointed in Android. Yes, to want to use the swipe away the task, but it doesn't kill it. It doesn't kill the fucking task. It just leaves it, you know, it just removes it from your list.
It's supposed to kill it, is what they said.
It's not. It doesn't.
Okay.
Oh, no. I'm so disappointed.
I'll have to look on...
Nobody can get their shit together. iOS, it takes an eternity to do a goddamn thing. I mean, that son of... you know? It takes forever just to do anything on that thing. God forbid switching tasks on that thing, and I hate the goddamn home button all the freaking time with that stupid operating system. Android, I don't know. It's confusing from one phone to the other. I mean, I've owned two Android phones that behave differently. No, and I hate the damn 6 app shit. And I don't want to freaking have a third-party thing.
What do you mean by the 6 apps thing? Are you referring to
what I'm talking about with the damn recent things? Will they stop saying recent? This shows your recent apps that I had open. I want all of this, like WebOS, and I can look, I can zoom out and bam, there it all is. Boom, kill, done. Fucking shit.
Can anybody tell our bit is very angry that his WebOS is being taken away from him? It's like a 2-year-old when you take away his favorite toy. He's like, mine!
Oh my.
At least you're on grandfathered data, so you don't have to take advantage of the... When I saw the commercials and the advertisements and the pushing from Verizon, I was like... Oh, well, if you hadn't screwed people to begin with, this wouldn't be this. You know, apparently for the holidays, Verizon's being nice, and anybody who signs a contract gets double the data. I'm like, oh, how nice of you. You'll rape them half as much.